What if I tell you that the Annapurna circuit rack is dying? Hi guys, Manav here and I welcome you all to Creedas. Now the road construction on the Annapurna circuit rack started in the early 80s and it is still going on as you watch this video. Now it used to take around 3 weeks to complete the Annapurna circuit rack when it came into being. And now only 5 out of these 3 weeks is without a motorable road. To understand this, I want you to focus on 4 locations on the Annapurna circuit trail. The town of Beshishahar, the village of Manang, the town of Muktinath, and the last, Tatopani. The Annapurna circuit trek starts from the town of Beshishahar. A road has been constructed from Beshishahar going all the way to Manang, a 95 kilometer long stretch. The route between Manang to Muktinath, which is around 35 kilometers, is a proper trail. Here, there are no roads at all. Next, the town of Muktinath is connected to Tatopani through an approximately 60 kilometer long road. So basically, out of the approximate 180 kilometers, only 35 kilometers is a proper trail. If you ask me now, is it worth doing the Annapurna circuit trek? Then also my answer will be yes. But before jumping into explanation, I want every person watching this video to acknowledge the importance of these roads for the people living in the Annapurna conservation area. Guys, road construction is not a bad thing. It is the rural road network that connects the village population with the mainland. The roads reduce the transportation cost of goods reaching to these remote areas, helping them experience a decent standard of living. It is the same roads which will send their kids to school. It is these roads which will provide them better medical facilities and quick responses in case of natural calamities like earthquake. But at the same time, I also understand that road construction will drastically impact the experience of a trekker. But if we have to study the impact of road construction, we should first acknowledge the importance of these roads for the socio-economic development of all the people who are living in these regions. Now, with that said, let me explain why you should still do the Annapurna circuit trek. If you'd notice, the Beshishahar to Manang road is not wide enough to accommodate big vehicles like buses. You will see either bikers or jeeps carrying people who want to go till Manang by road. There are literally very few personal vehicles on this road, thus keeping the area devoid of noise pollution. Further, this stretch can be avoided by using alternative side trails. According to my experience on this circuit in October 2019, there are these beautiful side trails that you can take, that you must take to avoid the road for almost 80% length of this section, and you can trek peacefully for most of the time. The side trails go through beautiful villages and hamlets. You will see numerous waterfalls all along the trail. You will be crossing many beautiful suspension bridges and farmlands with mesmerizing views of the Annapurna mountain range. You can watch the first 3 episodes of the Annapurna video log series to know more about how these side trails look like. I found these side trails on an open source navigation application known as maps.me, available on both App Store and Play Store. And since the Annapurna circuit is a very popular trail, almost all the side trails are mentioned on this app. I will be coming up with a video dedicated to the use of maps.me on the channel soon, and then with a few hands-on assignment, you can learn how to use this application in the outdoors. Okay, moving on to the next section, that is Manang to Muktinath. This is the area where you see the high altitude mountains really up close, and in my opinion, one should definitely spend more time on this section by adding the Thilichur Lake trek to their plan. The trail to the lake is still pretty much conserved, beautiful, and is challenging. So by doing this side trek, you can be on the trail for long and it will also help you acclimatize well. Thilichur Lake is the highest glacial lake in the world and will add beautiful memories to your overall trekking experience. The Thilichur Lake side trail will add another 30 kilometers to your overall plan. Moving on to the last section, that is Muktinath to Tatopani. I would suggest every trekker to take a bus instead of hiking this section of the Annapurna circuit. And I can give you good reasons for this. Muktinath is an important pilgrimage location for the Hindus and Buddhists. During the spring and autumn season, there are buses, cars, taxis and bikes coming all the way from Pokhara, making the whole route very dusty and a nightmare for any person who decides to walk on this road. Now there are new side trails on the Muktinath Tatopani section also, but while you are on these side trails, all you see on the other side is the vehicles and the dust. Further, all the accommodation on the Muktinath to Tatupani trail are along the road. So every evening, finally, you have to get down, cross the suspension bridge, go on the other side where the road is and spend the night. And this is not the case with the Besi Sahar to Manang section of the road. So therefore, in order to summarize, the Annapurna circuit trek is still worth doing, but only if you take the side trails from Besi Sahar to Manang and also add Tilichol Lake to your overall plan. Guys, the Annapurna circuit trek is still a moderate level trek, and you need to do a lot of planning if you want to execute it well, because still there is a good amount of opportunity to hike some 150 kilometers on the Annapurna circuit trek without touching the road. So it is important to acknowledge the fact that the road construction along the Annapurna circuit trail is increasing every single year, and soon this trek will convert into a road trip. So if you want to do this trek, you should do it in the next couple of years. But for now, as of now in 2020, Annapurna circuit trek is still worth doing, and with enough research and preparation, even a beginner with good fitness levels can do this trek all by him/herself. So guys, this was all for today's video. In the next video, we are going to talk about top 10 tips which will help you speed hike the Annapurna circuit all by yourself. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.